Hey guys, this is Dr. Akshay Bhandari. I welcome back to you to my channel, Akshay Bhandari's Dental Videos. So today we'll be discussing about parts of cast partial denture. So before starting up the video, if you like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, Akshay Bhandari's Dental Videos, and hit the subscribe button. So let us start with the parts of cast partial denture. Cast partial denture, basically it is a removable partial denture consisting of a cast metal framework and an artificial teeth set in an acrylic resin. So in addition to the acrylic partial denture, the cast partial denture has a cast metal framework, and over this cast metal framework there is an acrylic resin over which the artificial teeth are set. Now comparing the cast partial denture with the acrylic partial denture, so as cast partial denture has metal framework, so they are obviously more stronger, more durable and more retentive. Coming on to the parts of cast partial denture, so we have connectors which connects the various components of the cast partial denture. So in connectors we have major connector and minor connector. In case of retainers, so retainers, their main function, as the name suggests, they help in the retention of the prosthesis. So under the retainers we have direct retainer and indirect retainer. Then we have rests, denture base and teeth. So in the figure we have all the components labeled. So in this today's video you'll be just seeing that what is the main function of each and every component of the cast partial denture. Moving on to the major connector, so this is the most rigid component of the prosthesis. So major connector is that part of an RPD that joins the component and parts on one side of the arch to those on the opposite side, that is the components which are present on right as well as left side. So these components on both the sides are being connected with the help of the major connector. So major connector, on connecting the various components of cast partial denture, it leads to the unification of prosthesis. That means it connects all the components and converts the prosthesis into a single unit, and this provides the rigidity to the prosthesis. Hence the major connector, it is the most rigid part of the cast partial denture. Moving on to the rest, so rest, it is a small projection of metal from the denture or the major connector that rest on the surface of the natural teeth. Main function of the rest is it transmits the force along the long axis of the abutment tooth. Hence it exclusively provides support to the prosthesis. The other functions of the rest are it maintains the clasp palms in the position. As we can see in the figure, from the rest the clasp palms arises, that is direct retainer, which we are going to learn in the further slides. So this clasp assembly, they arise from the rest. So basically rest helps in maintaining the clasp palms in the position. Rest sometimes also acts as an indirect retainer, and it directs the food away from the tooth contact and embrasure area. So the main function of the rest is to provide support, transfer the forces along the long axis of the abutment tooth. So coming on to the next part of the cast partial denture, that is direct retainers. Whenever the cast partial denture is placed into the oral cavity, there are three factors which are usually responsible for the dislodgement of the denture. First is the gravity. In case of maxillary denture, it might be responsible for the dislodgement of the cast partial denture. Then there are functional forces which acts across a fulcrum line, and third is the adherence of the food. So these are the factors which are usually responsible for the dislodgement of the cast partial denture. So in order to prevent the dislodgement of the cast partial denture because of this factor, there is a component which is applied to resist this movement away from the teeth or tissue, and this provides the retention for the prosthesis, which is called as direct retainer. So basically direct retainer, it provides the dislodgement of the prosthesis away from the teeth or tissue because of the various factors. Direct retainers, they ensures effective prosthesis retention and minimizes the transmission of detrimental forces to the associated abutments and supporting tissue. So in the picture we can very clearly see that the direct retainer, they encircle the tooth as much as possible, and this encirclement over the tooth surface, it provides retention to the prosthesis. And mainly the function of the direct retainer is to resist the movement of the prosthesis away from the teeth or tissue. Moving on to next, that is indirect retainer. So indirect retainer, it is mostly active in case of the distal extension denture bases. So whenever the distal extension denture base is dislodged from its basal seat, it tends to rotate around the fulcrum line. So this movement around the fulcrum line, it leads to the movement of the prosthesis away from the tissue, and this movement of the prosthesis away from the tissue is resisted by direct retainer or rest or major connector. So basically the component of an cast partial denture which assist the direct retainers in order to gain the retention of the prosthesis is called as indirect retainer. So basically indirect retainer, it is present on the opposite side of the fulcrum line away from the distal extension edentulous area. So how a position of an indirect retainer is being decided? So it is usually being decided by drawing a perpendicular from the existing fulcrum line. So what is a fulcrum line basically? Fulcrum line is the line which is drawn along the terminal abutments or along the distal rests, as we can see in the first figure, which is being labeled as clasp axis. So that is the fulcrum line as it is being drawn along the terminal abutments. Terminal abutments are those abutments beyond which there is an edentulous space. Whenever the fulcrum line is drawn along the terminal abutments or along the distal rest, we draw a perpendicular to this existing fulcrum line as shown in the second figure. And that perpendicular line, whenever we draw it, it meets to the specific area of the specific tooth. So that tooth, it is considered to be the site for the indirect retainer. Because indirect retainer has to be away from the fulcrum line in order to prevent the dislodgement of the denture. So drawing a perpendicular from the existing fulcrum line is going to shift the indirect retainer as much as possible away from the fulcrum line. That is why we draw a perpendicular from the existing fulcrum line. Moving on to next component, that is minor connector. So the main function of the minor connector is to connect the major connector to all the other components, that is indirect retainer and rest. This itself forms the main function of the minor connector, rest. This provides rigidity, unification, bracing or stabilize the cast partial denture, and also helps in the retention of the prosthesis. In addition to the joining function, the portion of the denture framework by which the denture base is attached also acts as the minor connector. Coming on to last, that is denture base and teeth. So usually denture base, it supports the artificial teeth. They receives the functional forces from the occlusion, helps in transferring the functional forces to the supporting oral structures, aids in the mastication of the food, stimulation of the underlying tissues, and it adds up to the cosmetic effect of the replacement. So I hope you guys have liked the video. If you have liked the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel Akshay Bhandari's Dental Videos. If you need any videos to be made, kindly comment the topics in the comment box. So accordingly, I'll make the videos.